And now we have our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhanta Bal, joining us live from Colombo, from outside the St. Anthony's Church, which was the scene of massacre yesterday, one of the church which was attacked. But Siddhanta, what we understand now is that there is another bomb that has been detected near this church.
Well, I'm standing right in the center of a lot of developments right now happening. There were two developments which happened in the last 1 hour, one behind the church and one back in front, behind me. And what happened is just that people started running, and it's believed that someone was carrying a parcel and running, and suddenly the security forces suddenly jumped in. And right now there is a lot of commotion and chaos. You can see on your screen a lot of people standing there, and security personnel inside that alley, which you can see where there was just 5 minutes ago a lot of commotion. It's believed that there might be some undetonated device, and that is why some the security personnel, including some of the people who can in a sense defuse the situation, have just gone there and they asked us to vacate the entire area. So we are just standing towards the corner. If I can show the church is just behind me. Initially we were not allowed to go near the church, but the situation developed so rapidly that the security personnel allowed us to stand here just in front of the church. And if my camera person can just show the church, the in front of the church, which was never allowed to the media, and for first time it's being allowed to any in media, especially Indian media. This is the in front of the church, which is completely devastated. You can see the entire front portion which has been destroyed. If my camera person can show the destroyed doors of the church. This was the church, the historic church, that was destroyed. And of course, a lot of security personnel present. And of course, you can see, if my camera person can now pan, there is a police vehicle just entering that alley where there was a person believed to have taken that parcel. I have with me someone who was here. Sir, can you just talk about what exactly happened? So what happened exactly?
Well, of course, I saw that near to the police station, someone have ran. Is running here and there, and somebody told us that somebody have carrying a parcel and running towards that way. Mm-hmm. And after that, some people also having running here and there. Uh-huh. That after that, we all does not know what has happened there and what the incident have taken in that place.
So clearly situation rapidly developing here, and of course the situation remains quite tense in Sri Lanka. Emergency will be imposed at 12 midnight here, and we also know that politically also the country is going towards a not so stable situation, with a minister from the government clearly saying that there were intelligence report and those intelligence report were not given to concerned authority. And then of course the situation developed even before 10 minutes before the incident happened, the terror attack happened. There were reports given that that this kind of incident can happen, but nothing was taken. But right now, as of now, the situation rapidly developing, and you can see a person has been caught. There is the media personnel along with the police personnel dragging that person. Something has happened. Lot of things have happened. They have captured a person. They have captured a person carrying some kind of explosive device. Right now, the police is also present. Everyone is running towards that location. A lot of development happening in last 15 minutes in front of the St. Anthony's Church, where the bomb blast took place just yesterday. And now you can see more development happening. The entire world media present here watching the entire development which is happening. So clearly a lot of commotion, a lot of chaos, and of course police personnel also now running towards that location. You can see
our principal diplomatic correspondent Siddhanta Sabal reporting live from outside St. Anthony's Church in Colombo. Siddhanta, requesting you to please stay safe, even as you continue to bring us all the latest updates. Ladies and gentlemen, these are live visuals coming to you from with our reporter standing by over there. So Siddhanta, for now, everybody is converged right behind you. And for now, it looks like this person has been cornered and captured.
Well, of course, someone is captured right now on your screen who has been captured by the police. This is fresh development taking in on your camera screen right now. That person was found running with a passer. There were rumors, and now the development might be indicating towards capturing a personnel. But of course, right now we have been asked to stay away because there might be explosive devices around this area, and that is why every media person is making sure that he stays away. But clearly the voice, the chaos is just growing from this place. If my camera person can just show the number of people who are standing, there's a sea of humanity which is standing right now here in front of the church, and of course everyone gathering around that personnel. But the development happened so fast that it was clearly scary at one moment that just this place saw a terrible attack, the bomb blast, and now just 24 hours after that attack, this has happened on your screen live. You can see someone being captured. I don't want to speculate into anything, but what I am gathering from here around the situation is he was carrying a parcel. This could be anything. This is the same location where the bomb blast took place yesterday. This was the place which destroyed the church, which you saw on your screen. And now you can see the commotion, the absolute commotion in front of the church of that person being captured. He could be a petty thief, or he could be carrying anything, but this is clearly very, very scary in a country that has lost 200 people yesterday only. It's still mourning the loss of life, the people who lost their life, and now just 24 hours after that, Vion is capturing those visuals in front of you, the developing situation which is happening just today morning at the airport. We just left the airport, and then there was this report that a bomb was found that was defused successfully. We were just about to send our feed. We did some exclusive interviews, and suddenly the police personnel asked us to vacate the area and run towards a safe location. And now this has happened just on your screen. Everything happened in just like 5 minutes. The situation developing very, very fast, and a lot of camera persons going there, of course, risking their life along with many people who are standing there. This could be a person who could be carrying anything. Whether it's a plain simple parcel or just or something more sinister, but this is happening at the same location where the blast took place just 24 hours before, ripping the entire church apart, killing so many people. We spoke to the chief priest here, who clearly said that it's time to forgive those people who indulge in such sinister activities. It's time to move forward, but it seems that the development which is happening just in front of this church is clearly intending to move from sinister. We've been speaking to those people, but as of now, nobody is very keen to speak about, because everyone is right now scared. Somewhere they are anxious what has happened in the country, and that is why more and more people might be believing into something else. There's absolutely cut off, clamped down on social media, whether it's on Twitter, whether it's on WhatsApp. I'm not able to contact through WhatsApp for last 4 hours now. Only email is working. That is the situation right now here, and after the imposition of emergency, the situation might exacerbate more, it seems, because there will be complete cut off from communication. But hordes of journalists have descended upon this small country in South Asia, whether it's from Germany, whether it's from New York, and they have been talking what has suddenly happened here in this country. But it seems that the political instability, the long shadow of the two prime ministers, the saga of the two prime ministers, has finally taken its toll on the people of this country. We know that at just few weeks, months ago, this country had two prime ministers, two warring factions, and today the one minister comes out in a press conference, says that the intelligence reports were there, they weren't shared. One part of the government was not sharing the intelligence report with the other part, and that led to happen, which is quite frivolous. And at that time, at one point, also a story in itself on the government's government's working. But clearly, we have been asked to move around this place. We'll try to to go to the exact location. We are going towards the exact location. What has happened? It seems it's safe to go there. We'll try to understand what has happened. But by and large, the situation seems to heading towards calming towards now calming and now moving towards much more calmer part. But now you can see close visuals of what has happened. We'll try to ask what happened here.
I think they have caught one of the terrorists. I don't know what is the special news. People are telling they caught the one of the terrorists.
We will speak. What basically happened here? What?
They have found an unidentified parcel. So the bomb squad has arrived from the other side. I'm not able to confirm any of this. I'm just telling you what I'm picking up at the moment. They found a person. The police apprehended him. There was no reason given to his as to why he was apprehended. However, the people around, they started assaulting the apprehended. The police is now trying to keep him at a secure place.
So the police is now asking us to move from this location. But I've spoken to a few people who are clearly saying they've caught someone, they've got hold of some material which could be anything as of now. So clearly situation rapidly developing. I don't want to speculate, but there is a lot of anxious moments here when you see these visuals right in front of the church where the terror attack happened. A lot of people, someone was saying that they caught someone right now. Of course, the government has obviously not confirmed anything, but something really did happen here. It was sinister. It was dangerous. Coming just 24 hours after the terror attack which happened in that church, devastated that historic church here in Colombo. And there you have it. The situation really, really not calm in this country.
Siddhant Sibbal bringing us non-stop live coverage from Colombo. And Siddhant, requesting you to stay safe again, even as you continue to bring us all those updates. A new situation, ladies and gentlemen, seems to have emerged outside the St. Anthony's Church, which was the scene of massacre yesterday. And today, there has been an arrest of somebody due to an unidentified parcel that could have been an explosive device. We do not know confirmation on any of these details that I'm putting out right now. This is happening live right here on Beyond World is One. As we speak, as our correspondent Siddhant Sibbal is reporting live right behind him, a huge crowd of people gathering and from the crowd, Siddhant is being told that there was an unidentified parcel because of which there's a lot of tension. There's a man found along with it and he was apprehended by the police and taken away. That's what we understand. No official confirmation from the Sri Lankan government, but for now the situation seems to be returning to a certain sense of calm, but it's still developing there, Siddhant.
Well, there is some kind of relief, but of course there are anxious moments here. There are people, so many people standing here. Most of the people don't speak English here because this locality, there are a lot of Sinhalese. People who are not, even if they are willing to speak, they will not able to tell what happened. But we will try to ask. Of the location to the ground zero where the people were captured. This is the location where the incident happened. Anything could be here. Anything right now could be here. It is really a dangerous situation. But of course, the police personnel trying to make sure that the people go away. A lot of police personnel are right now present here trying to make sure that people go away from this location. This is the exact location, just few minutes away from this location where the blast took place. If I can ask some people, what happened exactly here?
I just came, bro. I'm just out of Newton.
Okay, so a lot of people coming, onlookers coming here after sensing some kind of development here, but seriously, this was the location where something happened. This was the alley where something happened, where people were seen running. This looks like not so well-off area, but this is the exact place where people were running inside, and suddenly there is a huge, huge police presence. And of course, you can see on the terraces, people are gathering, looking down as well. There is a lot of commotion right now here, and you can look at the people, the amount of people people who are standing. It will be curfew time very soon here in Sri Lanka, and these people will be, of course, not present here because they are imposing curfew with strict enforcement. But right now, it seems situation is quite tense. Of course, right now, calm but tensed, because initially there was a lot of chaos here. We will try to ask the police personnel if they would like to speak what happened, but it seems that they would not like to speak. They're just shouting to the people here, to the public, general public, trying to make sure that the public goes away from this entire location. Right now, commotion remains. People right now present here. A lot of people present here. This was the exact location. This was the exact location that the person was captured. This entire area. Someone was beaten here. Nobody knows what happened. But of course, as the people are telling, there was a parcel here. Situation clearly quite tense. Let me just ask police personnel here, what exactly happened? Sir, what exactly happened? Can you tell us, sir? So the police personnel are not very keen to talk to the media, and of course they are themselves very, very agitated because of what happened here. But right now, clearly the situation is calming down, but clearly it shows that the country is right now in quite a tense position, and this is likely to remain for a pretty, pretty, pretty long time. Today is just day one after the terrible attack, the attack which killed more than 200 people. The count is still on. There are many foreigners who have not still been identified. So clearly government is doing something else, but a lot of commotion all in this country right now.
Siddhant Sibal, our principal diplomatic correspondent, joining us with non-stop live coverage from Colombo. These are visuals from outside the St. Anthony's Church, which was the scene of massacre just yesterday, just 24 hours ago. And today, drama outside the St. Anthony's Church in the Kochikade suburb of Colombo. A man apprehended by the police after an unidentified parcel was found, leading to the people over there thrashing this man before the police walk into the situation and clearing them away, and situation slowly returning to normalcy even as the police are clearing away the locals from the scene. Our correspondent Siddhant Sibal is reporting live from the very location where chaos erupted just a few moments ago. Siddhant, if you have been able to get in a word from any of the people around, any more details on what exactly transpired over there?
This is the guy. This is the guy they captured. This is the guy they captured. We are showing you the guy who was captured here, who ran away. This, he's the guy who was captured and, of course, later on thrashed by the people here. So clearly, situation remains quite grim, and this looks like a scary location and a scary development. This guy is trying to plead to the police that he's pleading to the police that he hasn't done anything, but the rumor mill is, of course, working overtime here. People, of course, speculating that he could be the guy responsible for the attack, but there are saner voices. But by and large, this is what Sri Lanka today is. This is what is happening in this country, a country which really does not know in the aftermath of the attack, especially after that press conference which was done today, in which the government was clearly blaming the government itself, government versus government, which was happening. That is the situation in this country. Nobody knows how long the situation will continue, but this shows that this is a classic example of what Sri Lanka right now today is. Instead of celebrating 10 years of peace in the aftermath of the end of insurgency by the LTTE, today Sri Lanka has formed something else. There are, of course, more police personnel coming here, arriving here in full force. and trying to understand the situation, what has happened. There are other journalists as well, foreign journalists as well, who themselves are a little clueless of what is happening here, because the language is a big barrier here, because most of the people do not speak English, and most of the people only speak Sinhalese or Tamil. So that is the story which has happened in last 15 to 20 minutes, and there is kind of a stalemate which has now developed between the police and the locals here, but something it seems happened, and we will be getting the entire development soon. And that guy has, the guy who was captured is now being taken by the police somewhere else. The police has taken the person into the car. If my camera person can just show the person who is taken into the car. He is taken into this car. There, of course, he's the guy. He's the guy who's taken into car, and he is whisked off from this location. He was the guy who was captured. Nobody knows who this guy was, the mystery man, who this mystery man was. But this guy has been now taken from this location. He has been taken to a separate location somewhere else. But that happened quite fast. He was taken by the police personnel here, and in just few minutes from now, a police van came, took him, and he was whisked away from this location. Of course, this might not cause more stability in the area, or maybe people calming down. People are still shouting, but by and large, the person who was kind of responsible for the entire development has been taken from this location. There are heated conversations which are taking place right now. People talking to each other, conversing. Of course, a lot of rumors and speculations are also happening. The police personnel are not going to talk to any media, especially international media. But you can see on your screen the police personnel now asking the people to go away, since the situation has been normalized after that person being taken away from that location to somewhere else. So something happened. Nobody obviously wants to talk to. They're talking in local language, but the situation very tense in this country right now. And seems there has been another brawl which has begun between the police personnel and the local people here. They're fighting here. There are a lot of people from various communities also present here. It seems kind of a tense situation between the communities and the police personnel, the authorities. They are saying something to each other, and the situation remains quite right. Tense in front of the church. There is a heated debate which is going on. What is happening, nobody knows, but right. Quite a few tense moments here in front of the church.
Our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Subbal, reporting live with the latest on the chaos that seems to have engulfed Sri Lanka 24 hours after a series of blasts rocked churches and luxury hotels. And we here, we on World is One, will continue to bring you live latest updates, minute by minute coverage of the latest in Sri Lanka. But it's time now for a short break. But for now, this is Krishna Kumar signing off.